Good morning, students. Welcome to the English literature class. In today's class, we shall take up the lesson Letter to God. This is taken from your literature book, The First Flight, Chapter 1. It is written by G.M. Fuentes, a great Mexican author, poet, and even a journalist. So, as you see, the topic, the letter to God, is something very strange. We know that letter is generally written to the people. People write to one another. But here, the letter to God, something very funny. So, that's why automatically we find that this is very funny, humorous, and ironical story. So now, let us see, like in any story, there are some characters, protagonists. In the story also, we have the central character is Lenko. Lenko, and about this Lenko, we can say, he bears the three main character traits. First of all, he is a farmer, neither very rich nor poor. Then, he is simple, innocent, and he has a strong faith in God. So, this is the main characteristics of Lenko. Now, as we know that every profession depends on certain factors for its success, and if those factors are helpful, then that profession will flourish, otherwise it will fail. In the profession of farming also, cultivation also, some factors are very, very important. For example, farmers mainly depends upon the weather, rain, wind, climatic conditions, heat, and we find that this Lenko also undergoes the same experience with these factors. Now, let's continue. This Lenko has cultivated in his field the corn, and this is the time that his corn fields are full of flowers, and now he knows that it's the time to get good rain so that he can get a good harvest. As he is waiting for the rain, one day Lenko began looking up in the sky, hoping for a good rain, and he knew that the rain comes from the northeastern sky. So, according to his expectation and happiness, towards the evening, he saw the wind started blowing. Then he saw the rain clouds appeared in the sky and covered the sky. And soon the rain started. He was very happy. Happy because he got the rains as he needed. And he began seeing, watching the raindrops. And he saw that these raindrops were not like the real water. For him, they were like coins. They were the pieces of money, the gold coins. That's why he says the big raindrops meant same as 10 cents and small raindrops meant 5 cents. And these raindrops were like the golden coins because raindrops made the crops flourish, and when the crops flourish, he would get good harvest, and when he gets good harvest, then he would lead a good life, he would get a lot of money. That's why for him the raindrops were like gold coins. But the fate had its own way. As it was raining, suddenly the strong wind began blowing, and what he sees, he saw that hailstorm came. The big hails began pouring down from the sky. He saw everywhere the hens had covered. The hens had covered the crops, covered the trees, covered the roofs, and he found his crops were completely destroyed. And he told his children, "Look here, children, even the plague of locust would not destroy so much, but this hail had destroyed the crops completely." So then Joe felt very helpless, and he told his children that this year they would have very, very hard time for the survival. So he was quite sad. But Lento was a man of different character. He had full of hope. That is a good thing. He had a hope that everything is not over. He had hope that something will come on his way that would help him. And that was God. And for him, God would help him. He knew that God would not leave anyone to die of hunger, because he had known that no one dies of hunger. So Lento had great faith in God. Now only hope is in God. So let us see that God helps Lento in a very special way. So the whole night Lento began thinking about his family, his children, about his failed and help from God. He began thinking how to ask God. And we know that Lento was man of an ox, means he was great hard working man. He knew how to read and write. He was not completely illiterate. He was quite an educated person. He knew how to read and write. So he knew that through the letter the people can be communicated. He thought of writing a letter to God, and that's why letter to God, we had got the chapter's name, letter to God. So he wrote a letter to God complaining that, "God, if you don't help me, of my family will die of hunger. I cannot go ahead with the further cultivation." So after calculation, he wrote that he needed 100 pesos as help from God. He wrote it, went to the post office, fixed a stamp and dropped it in the mailbox. And quite satisfied, but quite sad also, he went back home. Now, something happens quite funny in surrounding environment in the post office. One of the employees whose responsibility was to collect the letters and forward it, he got the letter and began laughing, and he came to the postmaster bringing the letter, saying that, "In my entire career I have never seen any letter addressed to God, and look, this is a letter addressed to a God." Then postmaster, who was very amicable man, he had a round red face, he also began laughing. But soon he became serious. The postmaster became serious, and he began thinking, what kind of a man who wrote this letter and asking God to help him? Then he thought that this man must be having a great faith in God, and it is his duty to help him and not to break his faith, not to shake his faith in God. He should do something, and he should help him, and not only help only through sympathy, only through goodwill, but through the way this man wanted, that is through sending him money. So he requested his fellow employees to contribute some money in order to help Lento, and he himself contributed a good portion of his salary. And after collecting the contribution, he collected not the complete 100 pesos, but he collected only the 70 pesos that he put inside the envelope, and he wrote it to Lento, receiver of the letter, and writer of the letter is from God. He signed from God, and again he closed the envelope, and again he kept the letter. Then on next Sunday without any surprise, he came to the post office and began asking about the letter that he had written, sent to God, and he asked for the reply, if his letter reply has come. And I, to his happiness, but not much surprise, he got the letter, he opened the letter, and without any surprise, he counted and got only 70 pesos. Then he became anxious, he became annoyed, and he was quite angry. Then he began thinking, this is not possible that God can make any mistake in counting and sending money. Definitely, it is the work of the post office employees. They had cheated me. They took away 30 pesos and had given me only 70 pesos. So, what next? He wrote the letter again to God, complaining to God that, look here God, I know you would not make any mistake. I know you have sent me full 100 pesos, but these post office employees are crooks. They have cheated me. They have taken away 30 pesos. Please God, you send me remaining 30 pesos and make sure that this time you won't send the money through mails. Please send it in other ways directly to me. Then he wrote the letter, he closed the envelope and again he posted and mailed it into the mailbox. So this is the story, the summary of the story, the letter to God. Now students, what is the character trait? Now Lencho and the postmaster were the main characters here. Lencho, as we find, though he was poor, simple, but he had great faith in God. And we don't find any lack of faith in him. He had full faith in God. And it's a message for us that we should have faith in God. After all, we believe that when every door of help is closed, then God is there to help us. Next, we have got Akalencho, the postmaster. Postmaster was very sympathetic, very, very understanding. He was concerned and helpful. That's why he was ready to help Lencho. And in this way we find that letter to God is highly inspiring, though it is very funny, humorous and ironical. Yes, ironical, because you see, after all, who had helped him? The post office employees and the postmaster. But at the end he blamed them as crooks. This is the irony. That irony means something opposite of the meaning. That the helpers were blamed as crooks. So students, in today's class, that's all. Keep learning, keep safe. Thank you.